Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this afternoon's matchup between the Houston Texans and the San Francisco 49ers.
Well, Phil, we've got a terrific matchup at running back. Two of the most dangerous backs in the NFL about to meet, go toe-to-toe. How do you see it?
Well, you know what? It's not always about the quarterback when you talk about NFL games. And here's a great example of it today. The game of football is still about the most physical team wins. When you have running backs like this, the more physical team will win.
By the receiving team.
The defense accepts the penalty. Nickel formation for the defense here. First down and 10. Play fake here. Trying to work the middle of the field. Incompletion on that hurried throw.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
Oh, look at that. The defensive line shifted over to the left.
Frank Gore gets it here.
Good job here by the quarterback. He doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Secures it with two hands.
Confidence, it's an unbelievable thing, isn't it? When you get that first down in the game, it gives you a little confidence, and maybe most importantly, it gives your coach confidence.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Gore searching for space to the right. Nice tackle.
When you're going against a really athletic defense, there's nothing like reverses and the counter run game, because they see it, they go, and you counter it, and that's why it works to perfection.
And it's now second down and 5 after running it on first down. They hand it off to him again. The tackle is going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
Well, this early in the game, to watch the opposing offense march down the field and get inside the 20, this keeps the defense, they might be shaking a little, but if they stop them here to a field goal try or worse, that'll get their confidence back.
First down here. It's a throw all the way. Gets away from the heat. That's a gain of 6. Quarterback's calling something out.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive.
Whitney Merciless, unmerciful to the quarterback.
It is truly a bonus when you can take your outside linebacker and let him rush the quarterback and he can get a sack. Nice job that time by the outside linebacker. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of. Look at the hand signals he's given to the receiver.
Throws it in the end zone. Touchdown.
Tight ends are a position where you got to be able to do it all. You got to be able to block, run routes, and you got to be able to get in position so you have a chance to catch the touchdown pass. Good job by the tight end. Touchdown.
And after that extra point, the 49ers are leading by 7. The Texans ready to receive the kick. Will run this one back. Flag on the field. Boy, his head got yanked back the other way. An obvious face mask penalty, and that's a big one.
It's about safety of the players, too. That's why when you grab, hit the helmet in certain situations, it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Don't grab the face mask.
first down on the way. Here comes the wide receiver in motion. And the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster. And it's Patrick Willis who makes the tackle.
That's a terrible read by the running back. It's a short game, but it's all his fault. He picked the wrong hole. He should have cut it back. He didn't, and that's why he was tackled.
Back to the ground. And they bring him down at the 44-yard line.
You got to keep your offensive linemen aggressive, so you have to run the football every once in a while. That run, even though it was a short game, it served a purpose.
Challenging the defenders to the right side. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
I think the best thing to say about that play, it's just it gained a few yards, so that's what you do. All plays don't score. Sometimes you just want to pick up a couple yards.
Defense now signaling for a timeout. They've got a first down now after that catch. He'll go ground. He'll look for running room on the left.
Well, a short gain on the run that time by the offense. When you're a running football team, listen, there's going to be a lot of ugly plays that don't work. You just got to keep running it.
Phil Matschaub in his career has put up some pretty phenomenal numbers.
Yeah, it goes unnoticed down there in Houston, number Jim. You know, no matter what Matschaub does, you know, they go, the Houston Texans. And why it goes unnoticed? Because they haven't made it to the playoffs. And he hasn't been part of the national scene enough. So we haven't had a chance to look at Matschaub and give him the credit he deserves.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Hand off to the back. And that's good for only a yard or two.
You got to keep your offensive line aggressive. So you got to let them run the football so they can hit those defensive linemen. The run didn't pick up many yards, but it's still serving.
He's looking to the right here on this throw. Airtight coverage. Incomplete.
Number eight can't complete the pass. Third down.
The quarterback's hollering out instructions. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Third. And eight. Alden Smith with the quarterback takedown.
Outside linebackers who can get to the quarterback, they are a rare breed in the NFL because it takes talent, size, speed, everything to do it as a linebacker. And we saw it that time on display.
These defensive backs are ready for a battle. Press coverage all the way. This will be the eighth play of this drive. The wide receiver shifting around in motion. From the gun. Matschaub looking long. That's a touchdown, and that tightens things up.
Good job by the offense. They get in there. They tie this game up. Now we'll see if the defense can take advantage of that momentum and keep it on their side.
It's good. Texans getting ready to kick it away. They're not going to risk the big return, so here's the squib kick. And he is brought down at the 39. offense lines up here.
The D-line saw something on the offense. Everybody shifted to their left.
They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage. They bring in an extra defensive back.
Jim, look at that. The defensive line now shifting to the right.
No separation at all. Incomplete.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
The defense comes out in the nickel.
Flex round.
Dropping back three. The quarterback throws to the right. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
This is what drives coaches crazy. You make the quarterback throw it short, then you can't come up and make the tackle, and you give up a long game. You got your players in position. That's all you can do. Now it's up to them to make a play.
There's the quarterback barking out new signals. Looking to go up top again on first down. Barwin gets to him for the sack.
Nice job that time to the outside linebacker getting the sack. They ask a lot of these guys now. They are special players in the NFL. Stopping the run and the speed to get outside and get the sacks on the quarterback too.
Quarterback drops back. Ball's picked off.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just ran the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Tight ends in motion here. They motion the receiver around to the other side. Now first and 10. Takes it on the counter. Left side. And tackle down at the 49-yard line.
When you have a defense as fast as this one, they over-pursue. So that's why you want to run a counter run. Take advantage of the fact that they are just charging too fast, too hard, and not thinking on the defensive side.
Second down here after that run play.
Let's go.
Snap back to the quarterback. Out of the gun. Looking for a takeaway.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football. The results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
The quarterback mixing things up at the line of scrimmage. First down, offense readying for the snap. They'll go shotgun here. And he's forced to the ground.
It is truly a bonus when you can take your outside linebacker and let him rush the quarterback and he can get a sack. Nice job that time by the outside linebacker.
Second down coming up. Three-step drop. Looks to his left. Squeezes it into coverage. They pounce on him there.
You can't play zone coverage against this quarterback. He knows it's zone, and he's going to find the open throwing lane, and he gets it done.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play.
Back to the air here on first down. Staying with them stride for stride, and the pass is incomplete.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
The quarterback has his team's attention here.
Just a quick drop back.
Going for the home run.
49ers in for the score.
What a long arching throw by the quarterback. So beautiful. See it spiral in the air and right on the target for the touchdown.
Makes the PAT.
And after that extra point, the 49ers are leading by 7.
David Akers lining up for the kickoff. Begins his return. They tackle him at the 26-yard line.
Well, that time the kick returner just does an awful job. He doesn't read the blocks. His guys are knocking him down. He goes the wrong way, and that gives him bad field position.
Texans come onto the field now for this next series.
They face first down. The wide receiver in motion.
Screen. The quarterback throws it on the mark.
Well, the quarterback's just too worried about the stats. So he throws that short pass, picks up a couple yards instead of throwing it down the field.
The pass play was good for 5. Second and 5 coming up. Trying the right side.
The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
Well, it's about deceiving the defense, isn't it? That's how you get a lot done in the NFL. And when you can run and pass, you can deceive them in a lot of ways. Nice job by the offense, running that football, picking up another first down and moving the chains.
A tackle behind the line.
Second down following the run.
He drops back to throw, and he... Deshaun Goldson with the interception. Good piece of tackling.
Good job by the defensive back. Reading the wide receiver, makes the break at the perfect time, and gets the interception.
Good job here by the quarterback. He doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
He's into the open. He steps out. First down here. Now in rhythm, the quarterback drops back to throw once more. The defense doubled up on that one.
They call that the moment of truth. It's a beautiful throw down the field, but the defensive back, he waits until it's time to make that jump. He defends the pass. What a good job by the defensive back.
Flex round! Flex round!
And here we have second down.
Three-step drop, working that left side, knocked down.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
Look at that whole cadre of receivers on one side.
He's scrambling now. He'll throw it over the middle. And almost picked off.
The quarterback is going to hate himself tomorrow when he watches this tape. because you only get a chance for big plays in the NFL about three or four times a game. That one just went by.
The kick is good.
That was a good hold, good kick, 3 points. Good job by the offense.
49ers setting up for the kickoff. He'll have a chance to take off. That last play made by Patrick Willis.
What a good job by the kickoff team. The ball's kicked high in the air, and they sprint all the way down there. The blockers can't get set up. Nice tackle. Now they got great field position for the defense.
The Texans getting ready now to start their drive.
First down coming up.
The quarterback will hand it off.
Well, I know it's not going to make a highlight film, but still a good solid run up in there for a couple yards.
After the 2 yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. Out of the shotgun formation. Looking down the field. Wow, what a catch.
You throw it deep for a lot of reasons. One, you're hoping for the big play, maybe a touchdown, but also you got to think about interference. You can get that a lot of times, but that was a nice throw and catch.
Playing press coverage to the outside. Halftime, 2 minutes away. First down following the long play. The quarterback motions the wide receiver. First and 10. Here's the handoff out of the strong eye.
Nice play call that time by the offensive coordinator coming with the counter run. And the defense being too aggressive. They're over pursuing. So you do the little counter, go the opposite direction, and it works well.
Second and 4. He gets it again on this drive. They're in the hurry-up mode. The quarterback's calling something out. Third and 2 here after the run. Screen pass. The tackle is going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than 7, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. First down here after the completion. Ben Tate now with the carry. And that'll be a gain of about 2. Getting set as fast as they can. Play number 6 coming up on this drive. Second and 8. Staying on the ground. That picks up 7.
Well, even though they're down more than 7 here, the offense down the red zone, it'll be good for them for the rest of this game. Their confidence for the offensive coach, if they can punch this in for the touchdown.
Now the D-line going into that spread look. They want to get to that quarterback.
Here comes the wide receiver in motion. Staying on the ground. To the right side. Gains 11.
Well, when you get this close, it'll be nice to punch it in there and score. Even though you're still going to be behind, execute the play and get it done.
This will be the 8th play of this drive. Stay. Touchdown. This game is tight.
That's a nice touchdown there, and you're chipping away at that lead. Try to get into the minds of the opponent. Will they get tight? Do you hear the word choke? Yeah, I think they could be choking over there on the other side. Look out.
And the extra point is good. the 49ers in kickoff return formation. Now the smart play here is just to squib this one and avoid the big return. Get ready to start their drive.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of. Look at the hand signals he's given to the receiver outside.
Quick drop back. Heaving it down the field. Reaches in, and that pass is incomplete.
What a good job by the defensive back that time. That ball was thrown beautifully down the field. High arcing throw, but the defensive back in great position knocks it down.
A ton of defensive backs out here for this play. Catch made by Mario Manningham.
Quarterback that time realized it was zone coverage. He just waited for the defense to get out of position, and he threw it to the open hole.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up.
The quarterback throws the pass. Off the mark. The first half is over, and we'll be back with our first half analysis in just a moment.
We're back here now in this one where the 49ers lead by three.
Phil, we've got a good one going on here. How about breaking it down?
I'll tell you what a halftime lead does to a professional athlete. You go in there, it gives you tremendous confidence. You go, well, we just whipped their rear end for one half. There's no reason why we can't go out there in the second half and continue to get it done and win this game.
He thinks twice about returning this one and signals fair catch.
What a job by the kickoff team. The hustle. Everybody sprinting down the field, and they get rewarded. They give great field position to their defense.
Tough starting field position here. First and 10. Looking to the right side and throwing. It's Navarro Bowman in on the play.
Well, I guess the best thing to say there, Jim, is they completed the pass, but it still did not get a first down.
The quarterback's hollering out instructions. Second down and 6. Challenging the defenders to the right side. The tackle is made.
When you play zone in the NFL, what you're trying to do is make the quarterback hold the football just for a half a second longer, and you hope the pass rush can get there. They don't that time. That's why he got the completion.
First down and 10. Foster. He's brought down. Wasting little time. Looks like they're in press coverage here. After running it, it's second down. Drop back, shotgun formation. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Knocked out of bounds. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
In this game now, it's just so spread out. Everybody is so fast. You just can't avoid it. Concussions are just part of the game, and I hope he's okay.
Offense lines up here. Tight end in motion. Now first and 10. You'll get it in the weak guy. And a gain of 4. They're going to the hurry. From inside the red zone. Second and 6. They'll run with it again. To the right. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Good job getting the first down by the offense. A look at the defensive players on the sideline cheering their teammates on. Keep us on the sideline a little longer. That's what they're hoping for.
There's the quarterback barking out new signals. Play number six coming up on this drive. First and 10. On first down, it's back to the ground game. Time for the no-huddle offense. These DBs will not back off. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. The wide receiver shifting around in motion. Gets it again here. Fights that hit. They bring him to the turf.
Really important they find a way to score on this drive here, so close to the goal line. They got to get back in this game. And if they find a way to score, even though they'll still be behind, it'll give them a lot of confidence.
We'll run it with him again.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in the gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. They send the tight end in motion. They motion the receiver around to the other side. Back to the running back. Searching. Power serve for six. Touchdown. They're going to the hurry-up offense, and they're back to the line quickly. The point after try is in the books. And after that extra point, the Texans lead by four. Texans getting ready to kick it away. This kick will stay on the ground, avoiding a big return. And he is tackled at the 44. The quarterback mixing things up at the line of scrimmage. Nickel formation here for the defense. Trying to work that left side.
Well, it doesn't look like much, but it really serves the purpose. Picks up the first down, and now they have a chance to open things up.
The quarterback has his team's attention here. First and 10. The quarterback throws to the right. And he'll step out of bounds.
What a job by the quarterback, finding a way to throw that football and pick up another first down. They are marching down the field right now. Good job here by the quarterback. He doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving them hand signals.
They're going back up top. Going across the middle, incomplete.
Number 85, the intended target on the play. Second down.
Wide receivers bunched up.
Flex round! Ohio! Ohio! Flex round!
The quarterback's calling
Ohio,
something
Ohio.
Out.
Flex round! Flex round!
Dropping back three. Makes the grab. Touchdown.
Tight ends are more valuable when you get close to the goal line because they can use their body and push off and get open that way to score touchdowns. Nice job that time with a tight end.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this two-point try. Throwing now to his left. Could have taken the one-point gimme. They went for the two, and they are turned away. David Akers lining up for the kickoff. Setting up the return.
There is nothing like a good return when you talk about special teams. Good blocking. The speed of the returner gets down the field. And after that tackle, now they have good starting field position.
The 49ers ready to take over the football. The defense comes out in the nickel. three-step drop. No room to complete that one.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
About to take the snap inside the 20. Just a quick drop back. Looking for an open. What a catch. Touchdown.
What a throw by the quarterback for a touchdown. It was just really nice. He threw it beautifully right on target. Touchdown.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. LaMichael James, shake, and so they convert it here on the two-point drive. They line up here for the onside kick. They want that football back. The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. The Texans getting set now for their next series. Nickel formation for the defense here. The wide receiver in motion. Here's the handoff to Arian Foster. That's a tackle right near the 48. They're going to the hurry up. Back to the line. Second down here. Whoa, look at this. The D-line begins to spread out. Another handoff. They tackle him for a loss. Now third and four following the run. Looking for a receiver on the left side here. The tackle was made short of the first. And that'll bring up fourth down. Player showing no restraint coming in on the quarterback, and that late hit will cost his team 15.
A lot of times these late hits are called, and I feel for the defensive player. Not in this case. That was an easy call. A blatant late hit. It's worthy of 15 yards. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of. Look at the hand signals he's given to the receiver outside.
Looking to the right side and throwing. Wide open for the catch.
Well, anytime you're in the red zone, you want to punch it in and get that touch. Touchdown. If they do that, look, we're still going to be behind, but it gives them confidence moving forward.
After the long game, let's see what they do here. And the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster, wasting no time now for this next play. From inside the red zone, so dangerous. The quarterback motions the wide receiver. Another carry here. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
Again, the coaches tell us the same thing every week about defenses. Can we hold them to field goal tries and not give up the touchdowns? Here we are. They got more than a 7-point lead. Can you hold them to a field goal try? Well, we'll find out.
Here comes the wide receiver in motion. They feed him the ball again. He'll go to the left.
A lot of ways where the offense can go this time. They can run it or throw it. And even if they score, they're still going to be down. But it's always great to execute the play the right way.
Chip shot here. Minutes to go, and we'll return after this message and a word from your local station. Welcome back, folks. We're getting set for the start of the next quarter. A short field goal try on the way.
the field goal try. Yes, sir.
Jim, they get the field goal at that time, and it keeps the momentum on their side. It's positive energy. It makes you feel good. Now we'll see if the defense can carry it on.
Here's the kick, and this one's just a little squib kick. Bites off the hip. The quarterback's hollering out instructions. They bring in an extra defensive back.
The pigskin's on the ground.
And he's brought down by Connor Barwin.
Well, the defense always says, let's call some fumbles. Then when you cause it and you're not able to recover it, that is one emotional letdown.
There's the quarterback barking out new signals. Defense comes to the line, ready to pounce on that quarterback one more time. Can they get another sack right here?
Zone defense doesn't work in the NFL like it used to. Good job by the quarterback reading that zone and finding the open guy.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. The quarterback mixing things up at the line of scrimmage. They better hurry to get the snap. They're going to go counter.
He'll go left.
Good yardage picked up on that call.
When you see a long run like that, you know what it does? It just breaks the will of the defense. In the NFL, it's all about passing. You see all these wonderful things. But when it comes down to it, who can win the war up front? And you win the war by running the football. Great job by the offensive line that time.
The defense comes out in the nickel. Play clock's running down. Right back to him one more time. They've got him down there.
When you're going against a really athletic defense, there's nothing like reverses and the counter run game, because they see it, they go, and you counter it, and that's why it works to perfection. Defense is proud of the line of scrimmage. They're trying to confuse the quarterback.
The offense coming to the line inside the opponent's 20. He's brought to a halt.
When you see a long run like that, you know what it does? It just breaks the will of the defense. In the NFL, it's all about passing. You see all these wonderful things. But when it comes down to it, who can win the war up front? And you win the war by running the football. Great job by the offensive line that time.
They need to get the playoff. Well, as the clock is winding down, the offense would like to just run it out. He's got a San Francisco touchdown.
Well, you got a lead. Now you're